Hello all, my name is Amrapali Chavan and I am working as an assistant professor in computer department. Today we will see what is engineering economic decision. It includes the introductory part of what is engineering economy and how we can take the engineering economic decision. So first we will see the engineering economic decision process. In that we will see what is engineering economy. So actually it is a collection of mathematical techniques that simplify the economic comparisons. Then it provides a rational and systematic approach for evaluating a different economic decision. For example, if you want to purchase any new manufacturing equipment or product for your company, you need the engineering economic decision. Then for evaluating the different manufacturing method, in term of the economic value to the company, you need a engineering economic decision. Then the third example is in case of replacing the existing manufacturing equipment or existing manufacturing methods, you need the engineering economic decision. So as an individual or business person, constantly make a decision in our daily lives is important. So most are made automatically without realizing that we are actually following some sort of logical decision flowchart. Relational decision making is often a complex process that includes a number of essential elements. So in this concept, we can see how two engineering students approach their financial and engineering design problems using flexible relational decision making. So we can see how it will work. So there are some alternative in engineering economic decision. So these alternative are always present for any economic decision. It includes identifying appropriate alternatives is as important as if not important than evaluating the alternative. So there are some alternative evaluation variables. The first is initial cost, interest rate. That means the rate of return. Whatever you are investing, that you will get return in the business process. Then anticipated life of equipment, that is economic life. So the life of your actual equipment is your economic life, because you are investing in that equipment. Then annual maintenance or operating cost or benefit. Once you invest in any type of business, you will get benefit after selling that product. Then resale or retrieve value. So whatever you are reselling, you will get the benefit or you will get the resale value from that. So you can see this diagram. It explains the engineering economic decision or making the capital expenditure decision. So here you can see in manufacturing, engineering is involved in every detail of producing goods, from conceptual design to shipping. In fact, engineering decision account for the majority, some say 85% of product cost. So engineers must consider the effective use of fixed capital assets such as buildings and machinery. So one of the engineer's primary task is to plan for the acquisition of the equipment, that is capital expenditure. So as you can see, the first step is planning. After planning, you can see according to plan, you have to invest some amount of money. Once you invest the money according to your budget planning, then you will further go to the manufacturing process. It is actually the implementation of any business plan. So once you are successful in manufacturing, you will come along with your product. So in marketing phase, you can sell your product. In this case, you can sell your cars which you have already manufactured. So in marketing phase, once you manufactured and sell your product, you will get profit. So this profit should be more than your investment. So this is actually the engineering economic decision process. So with the purchase of any fixed asset or equipment, for example, we need to estimate the profit, which more precisely you can say the cash flows that the asset will generate during its service period. In other words, we have to make capital expenditure decisions based on the predictions about the future. Suppose, for example, that you are considering the purchase of a deburring machine to meet the anticipated demand for hubs and sleeves used in the production of gear coupling. You expect the machine to at least 10 years. So this purchase decision does involve an implicit 10-year sale forecast for the gear coupling, which means that a long waiting period will be required before you will know whether the purchase was justified. Next, why is the engineering economic important, or engineers are important in the economic decisions? So as we all know, engineers and architects are design the things and perform the project. So therefore, engineers and architects must be concerned with the economic aspect of the designs that they recommend and projects that they perform. Though, so they must have knowledge about the economics. So there are some roles of engineers in the business process. So engineers' role in business process, it includes the making capital, that is expenditure decision. Engineer is able to make the expenditure decision or take. Then next is large scale engineering economic decision. In case of large scale engineering economic decision, the economic decision that engineers make in the business differ very little from those made by the small designing. So in case of the large scale, you have to wait for the long duration. Next is impact of engineering projects on the financial statement. So the engineer must have knowledge about all the plus minus or positive negative or profit loss impact of the financial statements. So this is the introductory part of the engineer's role in the business. Thank you so much.